Those also have less training.
With it on your doorsteps. Here is the onslaught of crime, and how is it affecting you?
Today at 5, we gave the results of a joint survey done by the St. Petersburg Times and Channel 13, a poll of Bay Area residents designed to see how you're dealing with crime. Tonight, in our In Focus report, we turn to one of Tampa's roughest communities, where neighbors are cleaning up the streets by opening their wallets and turning to a little hired muscle.
Firearms, speed loaders, 6 rounds apiece. You have the scanner that allows us to know what's going on in the immediate area.
The tools of the trade.
This is the pepper spray.
Equipped for the unthinkable.
It'll incapacitate you and drop you to your knees.
They go by the name of Critical Intervention Services, or CIS for short. They're a protection service that's trained in anti-terrorist maneuvers. Bodyguards for dignitaries like Archbishop Desmond Tutu.
Ambush!
But here their job isn't executive protection. It's the down and dirty work of ridding the 15th Street corridor, the veritable heart of Tampa's so-called suitcase city, of a crippling plague of crime. CIS President Casey Poulin.
The law enforcement is doing the best that they can. The problem that is just they don't have enough officers per capita. So we come into the picture basically to supplement and try to prevent crime from happening.
You might want to ID one of the residents that said he's a dealer.
It's part of a growing trend that has local businesses going outside the overworked and understaffed police departments to the private sector in an effort to get crime out of their properties. Carol Nash manages the Sandpiper Apartments, one of at least 4 such complexes along the 15th Street corridor, divided to the SWAT team-like presence of CIS.
We have seen burglaries, we have seen cars being affected, we have seen drugs, we've seen just about everything.
To the kids of Suitcase City, the telltale signs of a community in crisis are an everyday reality.
Somebody got shot behind the stove before.
Get that, we're just going to patrol this area, let us know when you're coming over and we'll meet you.
But since the stepped-up presence here, many feel the neighborhood's on the rebound.
Before, it was a lot more violent, very violent. Drug area, but now that they're here, it's safer. The crime has gone down, and the drug problem has ceased.
Since they have been here, we have seen a big difference.
They're not welcomed by everyone. That was evident when one of CIS's patrols was ambushed in a drive-by shooting. No one was hurt, and such resistance is no surprise.
We are targets, and because we're pushing the activity southward, you know, you do make a lot of people angry.
That's the bottom line, to push the dealers, the buyers, to push crime out of their turf.
This ain't the place to do it. Find another place, because where we're at, where these guys in black are at, it's not gonna happen.
The fear of home invasions like this one has given rise to private...